On Wednesday, the Sing for Democracy campaign held an international conference on human rights in Azerbaijan, existing problems and future prospects. The conference achieved unexpected and unprecedented levels of government attendance. The mix of international experts, officials from the presidential administration, members of parliament, NGO leaders, human rights activists and representatives of independent, pro-government and pro-opposition media made for tense and combative debates. Discussions focused on freedom of expression, journalist safety, transparency of broadcasting, economic and political freedoms, legal and political restrictions on socio-political activities, local and international mechanisms for human rights protection, and so on. Numerous foreign media representatives who have been accredited to cover Eurovision filmed the event. The main goal of the event is to push forward Azerbaijan's actual integration with Europe and to promote measures for the improvement of human rights situation in Azerbaijan, said Sing for Democracy coordinator Rasul Jafarov. Emin Sionov, chairman of the Institute for Reporters' Freedom and Safety, believes that they have managed to attract international attention to the state of human rights in the country. We have brought local and international attention to the issue of fundamental human rights in the country. There has been a great deal of interest from the European media. This is the first time in all my visits to Baku that I have seen such a large numbers of government and civil society representatives together in the same room, said Florian Erminger from Human Rights House. Experts commented that there are limited numbers of independent media outlets in Azerbaijan and their financial security is dire, and that there are difficulties in the distribution of newspapers. State representatives claim that there is media freedom in Azerbaijan, though they did admit to financial issues and difficulties in broadcasting. The basic challenges for the Azerbaijani media are poor access to information, a general lack of professionalism, non-compliance with ethical codes, and the government's failure to decriminalize defamation, believes Tranyz Agency director Mehman Aliyev. Experts noted that defamation law poses a serious problem. While journalists are no longer arrested under specific defamation charges, they face other potentially trumped-up accusations, for example drug possession. There are currently 8 journalists in the custody. Between 2007 and 2011, there were 400 lawsuits against media. In 167 cases involving defamation, journalists were demanded to pay collectively a 10 billion manats in compensation. The European Court has ruled on 2 of these cases and 50 are still pending, said IREX legal expert Asker Mehmetli. Shahvelat Chobanoglu, head of the Alliance for the Protection of Political Freedoms, claimed that the circulation of newspapers is worse now than it was 138 years ago when the first Azerbaijani newspaper Akinci was published. Government representatives were grilled about the victims of free expression in Azerbaijan. The editor-in-chief of Monitor magazine Ilmar Sinov had been asking questions about the source of the first family's money before he was fatally shot in 2005. After Bizim Yol newspaper editor-in-chief Bahattin Hasiev asked about the financing of the Heydar Aliyev Foundation, he was kidnapped and tortured. Azadlik newspaper editor-in-chief Ganimet Zahid accused the president of corruption and found himself under arrest. Radio Liberty correspondent Khadija Smailova had secret cameras installed in her home and became the victim of a blackmail attempt after her investigations into the private business interests of the president's family. Ilgar Aliyev, the head of the socio-political department of the presidential administration, condemned the alleged politicization of Eurovision. Azerbaijan has become a subject for discussion in mainly the British and German media. Eurovision Song Contest has never been so politicized for the whole of its history, he said. Other government and pro-government representatives supported him. They cited government support for the media grants and houses bid for journalists. Government representatives unanimously rejected all the criticisms regarding violations of freedom of expression and other human rights.